Parabelflug und Schwerelosigkeit. Die Woche steht voll unter dem Motto ZeroG und meines Außeneinsatzes mit der Deutschen Raumfahrtagentur im DLR. Damit diese Flüge möglich sind, braucht man neben einem speziellen Flugzeug auch einen sehr erfahrenen Piloten. Oder eigentlich drei. Ich durfte ins Cockpit und habe mir erklären lassen, wie man diese Parabeln fliegt, warum man dafür drei Piloten braucht und was den besonderen Reiz für den Piloten ausmacht. Herzlich willkommen zu Senkrechtstarter, dem Raumfahrtkanal im deutschen Sprachraum.
So, I'm here with Stefan. Hey, Stefan.
Hallo.
It's for me the first time in the cockpit, so I probably would not recognize something that is different to another airplane. Do you need something special for the parabolas?
Yes, we have some special yoke on this side, this one. This one is the standard one. You can push it and turn it. But this one, you can only push. You can only push, you cannot make roll the aircraft with this one. The other pilot will only take the roll of this aircraft with this. On the standard yoke, you can put some roll input, right or left, the second pilot, and the first pilot can only put some pitch down or pitch up.
And what's with the pedals? So for what do you need them, or who is in control of that?
The pedals, it's very simple. We don't touch the rudder pedals during parabola. We don't touch.
So you're flying a straight line, so you do not need it.
Keeping roll at zero for the wings, and we are just put some pitch input, but no rudder input. So rudder pedals, we don't use during flight parabolas.
So you need at least two people to do this, but how many people are in the cockpit?
I need three peoples. One for the roll, one for the pitch, and a third one here for the thrust levers.
Ah, so every lever is for one engine, and so...
Yes. We have two engines on this aircraft, so two throttle levers, one here for the engine number one on the left, and one for engine number two on the right. And the third pilot is only use this throttle lever manually during our flight.
So why is there... the engine or the thrust so important for your kind of maneuvers? Why do you need another person for doing this?
It just to put manual thrust, full thrust at the beginning, and idle thrust just before the zero G acceleration, and you have to check all the engine parameters during the maneuver. It's for this third pilot.
I've learned that the parabolas, the airplane is not in zero G exactly because you need a little bit of thrust to compensate the air drag, right?
It's right. We are near the zero G, very close to the zero G, but with the thrust lever, we can stay close.
And what controls are the most important, or an instrument is the most important to do this kind of flying?
The most important instrument is this one with the accelerometers. We can pilot and we can stay at a perfect zero G with this instrument.
Cool. So I've learned that you can do zero G, but it's possible to do with an airplane like Mars gravity or Moon gravity. Have you done that before? Or
yes, of course. We can change on this instrument the gravity target. We can put Moon gravity, Mars gravity, or everything we want.
And is this more complicated, or is it similar to doing zero G?
It's quite similar. But we have to be trained because the thrust will change, the different setting will change. If we change the gravity for the pilots, there is some little changes. So we have to be trained for this special parabola to Moon or Mars.
So, and this pilot is like doing the pitch?
Yes, the pitch. By pulling or pushing this yoke.
So this is probably why the instrument is on this side, because he's mostly in control.
We have the same on your side, and we can change this one and put on this one. So we can do the pitch on both sides.
Really, really interesting. Inside the cabin, we all had to be strapped, or just in the cage, we were allowed to free float. I think it must be complicated to control in zero-G, or...
For us, for the pilots, we are strapped with this harness. We have one, two, three, and we take this shoulder harness. So we have five harness. So we are good in the seats. We are good.
And how much practice does it take to do a parabola that you can use it for science?
At the beginning, the training was some simulator session, and after we need 4 to 5 flights to get this special qualification.
And so there are always like more experienced people on this flight, so the people who need to learn it can learn from the experienced people, or is it just like hands-on doing it?
Yes, flight after flight, we have more experience, so we try to get better and better each flight to perform a perfect parabola, but it's not easy.
So the parabolas, there is a lot of movement, so you're up and down, and you have to do it all manually. So I think this probably is like a really challenging or interesting job, because you have to do so much, right?
Yes, of course. It's challenging and it's interesting, because it's very different from a line pilot job. We perform all the maneuvers without autopilot, without auto thrust. Everything is fly manually, so it's very challenging for a pilot, and I think all the pilots enjoying this kind of flight.
I've once read or heard that a lot of people that are doing zero-G flight, or like a lot of pilots, are or had a military career before, so that they are military or jet pilots. Is that true?
Yeah, it's... For a part, it's true, but most of us, we are from French Air Force, but we have Thomas Pesquet, the famous French astronaut, is not from the French Air Force. It's a pure civilian pilot, but all the others, we are from the French Army.
Has ever a parabola went wrong, or do you have like problems that you said like, okay, we have to stop it?
For me, I have more than 3,000 parabolas, and no big problem. Okay. No, just some turbulences, so the zero G was not very, very good, but during 3,000 parabolas, no big problem. Very good aircraft.
So you probably know exactly how good the zero-G is, because you have this indicator, so you know after a parabola how well it went, right?
Yes, we have some captors everywhere in the aircraft, so we can see after the flight. We have a debriefing, and we can see if the zero-G was very close to the zero or not so close. We can see everything.
So I see a lot of manual controls and manual indicators. So the airplane is in good shape, but it's a little bit old. I think it's from the 80s or 90s.
Yes, you're right. You can see many needles and some screen, of course, but it's an 80s aircraft, Airbus aircraft from the 80s. Now in the new Airbus, you don't have all these needles of this old instrument. You only have screen like this.
Mm-hmm. And is it a big difference for a pilot to flying this plane and seeing these needles when he's used to seeing just screens, or have like jokes sticks?
The main difference to perform parabolas, it's to use the old flight controls like this, with yoke connecting to the flight controls with cables. This is very, very good to fly a good zero-G. We don't know with a side stick and fly-by-wire aircraft, yes. We don't know at this time if we have a good zero-G or not. We don't know.
Interesting. I saw the tanking truck near the aircraft, so it's tanked now for tomorrow, right?
Yes, that's right. They are refueling for the flight of tomorrow. Yes. Mm.
So you know now where you're going to go tomorrow. So I've seen some flights over the Mediterranean. You cannot do that, right? With the
we can fly near the Mediterranean area, but the day before we check the weather, we check the turbulences, the clouds, and we decide in which area the flight will take place the next day, so we can anticipate the refueling the day before.
Yeah, super, super interesting. And first time for me in the cockpit. It looks really amazing. What is the most cool part about this job for you?
It's a special job for a pilot. It's a special job because we take some high pitch. This kind of high pitch are very forbidden in the normal life, if I can say that. So we love to do some this kind of flight with an old Airbus. It's very very interesting, very challenging, and we like that kind of flight.
So a lot of people in the cabin, they are like researchers and they want to do research about the space. Are you interested in space and space flight, or is it while you're like a pilot and like aircraft?
No, I think we are interested in space. We know Thomas Pesquet. We have a lot of conversation with him. So we are interested in space and rockets, and not just the aircraft.
So thank you so much that you explained all that to me, and I wish you a lot of fun the next days. Will you be the pilot for the next days, or
just for tomorrow? Tomorrow morning I will be there, but the third flights I will be not here. It's another pilot.
Cool. Then have a nice flight tomorrow, and thank you for piloting us so great today.
Thank you very much.
It was
thank
really,
you to you.
Really, really cool experience, and was the first time for me. And yeah, I smiled the whole day, and I probably will smile a lot of more days to come.
Perfect. Very good. Very nice. Thank you. Thank you. You're welcome.
Das war mein Interview aus dem A310 Zero-G Cockpit. Ich hoffe, es hat euch wieder gefallen. Dann gerne ein Like da lassen. Und als nächstes, da schauen wir uns das Flugzeug von unten an und fragen die Technik nach den Besonderheiten und wie groß die Belastungen für das Flugzeug sind. Wenn du das nicht verpassen magst, dann kannst du hier Senkrechtstarter abonnieren. Hier geht wieder ein riesen Dankeschön an alle Schutzengel, die diese Reise möglich gemacht haben. Hashtag Team Space. Ich würde sagen, bis zum nächsten Mal. Immer schön senkrecht bleiben. Dein Mo.